This is the Canon EOS R5 Mark II. I have been putting it to the test for immersive filmmaking. From its new built-in digital IS stabilization to 8K 60 frames per second raw recording, in-camera VR preview, and next-level machine learning noise reduction, this camera is built for immersive creator aiming to produce the highest quality content on Apple Vision Pro or Meta Quest 3. In this video, I will talk you through everything I have learned so far. We will dive into all the key features you need to know about the R5 Mark II compared to the Canon EOS R5 right here and see how it performs in both photo and video shooting. Whether you are into VR filmmaking or traditional production, I will show you why this might be the best professional camera to invest in. Let's go! Unlike most review video you have seen already, I actually have the R5 Mark II on hand right here and have been shooting with it for the past 4 days. We even went to Cosm near SoFi Stadium for the Old by Circus Delay premiere event and shot with the R5 Mark II in low light and extreme low light condition. So, this is not just a surface level review, and you wouldn't be seeing just some basketball or breakdancing sample. You have been seeing everywhere else. Let's first cover the most important thing for VR filmmaker. The camera does support the RF 5.2mm f2.8 dual fisheye lens and able to shoot in 8K in 8192x1496 in up to 60 frames per second, just like the cinema level Canon EOS R5C right here. But there are several advantages compared to the old R5 or the R5C. First, the new battery LP-E6P allows you to shoot at Canon RAW light in 8K60 without the need for an external power bank or vlog battery like you see right here. Second, this is the first Canon EOS camera that has a built-in digital IS for the dual fisheye lens. This unlocks a new feature inside the EOS VR utility. On your left is the footage shot on the Canon R5C, and on the right is the new R5 Mark II. As you see, the stabilization options are entirely different. As there's no digital IS in the R5C, so the stabilization is purely software-based. The R5 Mark II right now has 4 new modes, all giving you better stabilization result. If you have the computing power like what I have here with the M3 Max MacBook Pro, I highly recommend using the prioritized accuracy mode and the prioritized stability settings. The biggest advantage of this new mode is the removal of motion blur jitter due to handheld movement or motion vibration, such as when you mount your camera on an FPV drone. It does not replace a gimbal, so please still use a gimbal for VR filmmaking if you plan to move your R5 Mark II. These modes are better for minor jitter that will appear even on an expensive gimbal, especially in 3D and VR. Just this feature alone is worth the upgrade, but Canon doesn't just stop there. It has VR preview, finally in the camera. Let me show you. Go to the third icon, page 3, and click VR preview. Select a fisheye video and play it. Now you can navigate the video using the LCD touchscreen on the back while the video is playing back. You can zoom in with your fingers to see the detail. This is an 8K 3D video, and having real-time interactive playback is insane. This is extremely helpful on set to see if you capture what you need in full 180 degrees. Thank you, Canon, for listening to our feedback and making this feature available for us. The VR preview feature also works on still, both in JPEG and 14-bit RAW format. You can pan and zoom in with your fingers and even use the set button to switch between the left and right eye to see the disparity. I wish they would also bring in anaglyph 3D mode in a future update so we can view it with 3D glasses as well. Canon does monitor our comment section, so if you want this feature or have other suggestions, please comment down below. Talking about immersive 180 photo, Canon also introduced in-camera upscaling and neural network noise reduction, two new features that use deep learning to enhance your image quality. The in-camera upscaling tool quadrupled the number of pixels in each image to generate ultra high resolution 179 megapixel image. This only works on JPEG, but since Canon EOS VR utility can only stitch JPEG in VR180, there's no problem with that. The Neural Network Noise Reduction tool helps you to reduce the noise in high ISO RAW images. So if you like to shoot RAW, go to your RAW photo and hit the Q button to select RAW Image Processing, then select RAW Image Processing Setup to convert to JPEG. Hit Set and go to the NR feature. NR stands for Noise Reduction. Select Neural Network Noise Reduction right here. You can further edit your RAW photo in camera, then save and save as a new file. It takes about 10 seconds to save RAW to JPEG, then go back to your menu, third blue icon, page number 2, select In Camera Upscaling and choose the image you just denoised from the RAW. You can easily identify it by the paintbrush icon right here. Hit Set on the touchscreen, then hit Q to confirm. It takes about another 10 seconds to upscale it. The final image is in 16K instead of 8K with much better quality for high-end VR headset like the Apple Vision Pro, which can display up to 16K VR content. So they really have the Apple Vision Pro in mind. This is going to be huge for time-lapse photographers. You can batch process a series of time-lapse photo in camera without needing an expensive software like Topaz Photo AI or a high-end computer. This camera is your high-end computer. Processing 16K time-lapse video that will blow people's mind on Vision Pro. Stay tuned for our Taiwan release on the Apple Vision Pro, which utilizes this technique exactly. R5 Mark II now also has Canon C-Log 2 as a custom picture profile. Go to camera icon and page number 4 under custom picture, select C2 for C-Log 2. Select edit CP file and under protect, select unprotect. Now you can load in a custom LUT as load file setup. So you don't have to look at the flat C-Log 2, but instead see a custom graded version. This enables a better workflow on set with your color list to show the director the final graded result with correct lighting setup. Thank you, Canon, for always thinking about what professional filmmakers need. Even though we have C-Log 2 now, it doesn't mean you should always use it. C-Log 2 gives you more dynamic range in RAW, but it tends to be noisier in low light and requires post-denoising. Take a look at EOS VR utility and go to RAW development. This is shot on C-Log 2 and this is shot on C-Log 3. You can see the noise in C-Log 2. Even if you max out the NR setting in RAW development, it's still a pretty noisy image at ISO 3200, which is what this clip was shot at. You will need to do extra denoising using Neat Video or DaVinci Resolve. If you hate doing extra work, take my suggestion and stick to C-Log 3 for now. I do believe Canon will release more helpful tools in the future to work with C-Log 2 on the R5 Mark II. For now, stay away from C-Log 2 in low light. By the way, you see this new lens correction setting? Chromatic aberration and peripheral illumination. Make sure to use them. This is a new feature introduced in version 1.4 that dramatically help improve RAW image quality shot on a dual fisheye lens. It will also help in the R5 and the R5C, but will obviously do better in the R5 Mark II right here. There is a new mode almost all reviewer missed. If you go to camera setting page number 3, there is a new setting called HF anti-flicker shooting. Turning it on will help remove flicker when you point the camera at a screen, like a LED wall for virtual production. As a VR camera seeing everything, I always turn it on to reduce flickers on screen, like a billboard display in Times Square or computer screen. For virtual production, you can use this feature to calibrate the refresh rate to match your LED wall exactly like this, resulting in silky smooth flicker-free virtual production. Drop me a like if you also do virtual production and this tip saved you. For audio, just like the R5C, R5 Mark II now also has uncompressed LPCM 24-bit 48kHz 4-channel audio recording. I know what you are thinking, spatial audio creators. This allow me to have a stereo mic like the Comic Car right here to capture a wider sound sphere and mix it with the onboard audio to create location-based audio. This enables spatial audio for Dolby Atmos and Ambisonic. Canon really listened to our community, even in audio. Canon R5 Mark II not only has better image quality, it also introduced some quality of life feature for VR filmmakers. First is this full-size HDMI, while the R5C only uses mini HDMI. Now you can also zoom in 8K 60 frames per second all the way up to 15 times zoom, just like the HEVC mode. This is not possible in the Canon R5C, by the way. It's really helped with narrowing that critical focus. The R5C has force color and a waveform monitor to help with exposure for professional. Fear not, now the R5 Mark II also had them. Go to page 9 of the camera setting, go into shooting info display. Here, you can turn on the waveform monitor and set the type. On page 8 of the camera setting, you can turn on log view assist to see RAC709 when you are in C-Log 2 or 3. But if you turn it off, you can now turn on force color here and check your force color index right here. Basically, pink color is where you want your subject skin fall onto. You can even set this up in the quick menu. Hit the Q button once and hold it down for 3 seconds and turn on customize quick controls. For VR180, I never use select a card, so I turn it off. Go to page number 2 and select view assist and force color here. Now, hitting Q once allows you to quickly select force color on and off. I just saved you 10 seconds on set checking exposure. Drop me a like and thank you comment down below. The R5 Mark II even bring in the quick cinema menu from the R5C. If you hit the Q button twice, it will go into the familiar menu for R5C user. From here, you can quickly access video settings, color profiles, and even turn on proxy recording. The R5 Mark II now even has a tally light for video focus professional. How cool is that? Is everything an upgrade compared to the Canon EOS R5 right here? Not so fast. While the R5C used the Cinema EOS OS system, not all its features made into the R5 Mark II. One glaring omission is the leveling feature during recording. Sure, you can see level before you start recording, but it disappears once you hit the record button. This is a major drawback if you are moving the camera and need to check the level live. This is a significant oversight, especially for professional filmmakers. So, as much as I appreciate the new feature Canon brought, it's clear that Canon still has some work to do. Please help by commenting below and urge Canon to bring the leveling feature to the R5 Mark II. It is important that they hear from us, the user, to make this camera truly the best it can be. Everyone complained about the overheat problem on the R5 right here, and in the R5 Mark II, there will still be an overheating problem when you are shooting in 8K 60 frames per second. You can greatly improve it for up to 2 hours of continued filming if you get the new battery grip. I don't have it yet, it is my next purchase, but to give yourself a little bit more filming time, go to the camera menu on page 10 and make sure to set the auto power off temp to high. This at least gives you a couple more minutes when you're shooting in 8K 60 frames per second. There are a lot more features I did not cover for 2D photo and video, but this is pretty much everything you need to know about the Canon R5 Mark II for VR filmmaking with the dual fisheye lens. Some viewer asked if the new autofocus dual fisheye lens right here is this comparable with the R5 Mark II? Well, when you connect the RF 3.9mm lens to the R5 Mark II, it actually turns the R5 Mark II into APS-C mode, so you still get a full fisheye coverage at 144 degrees. It's better than the R5C, which does not even work at all. However, in this mode, the autofocus does not really work yet, and it does not have the super sampling 4K fine mode. So for now, the Canon R7 is still better for the new dual fisheye lens, but it's just a matter of firmware upgrade for the R5 Mark II to support the autofocus dual fisheye lens as well. So it's promising, I will follow up on that topic for sure. In my next tutorial, I will review the regular 2D video and photo feature of the R5 Mark II. Since I have the camera and most other influencers do not have it yet, so feel free to ask your question in the comment section down below, and I will try my best to answer them all or talk about them in my next in-depth hands-on review and tutorial. The VR180 MasterCard is back, and now with the brand new flagship Canon R5 Mark II. I have only really touched the tip of the iceberg of this camera. Some influencers complain about the lack of impressive feature on the R5 Mark II right here, but most of them don't even have the camera on hand. I can tell you from my first hand experience, there are a lot of great feature, and this is definitely the best hybrid camera on the market today that you want to pay close attention to, whether you are for 2D or VR production. I will see you in the next review and tutorial. Ciao!